Hi, do you wake up sometimes in the morning and you're feeling that your penis is missing? Let's talk about it. In this video, we will discuss how we can help you. All you do is go to Himplant.com and fill out the questionnaires, and we will contact you within 24 hours. I'm Dr. Taj. I'm a board-certified urologist and penis enlargement surgeon. Who are the implant patients? Patients from all socioeconomic statuses, rich, middle class, low income, patients who are gay or straight, married, single, attorneys, doctors, engineers, military personnel, political people. They walk from all aspects of life and they want to improve their confidence in the bedroom and beyond. People come to me every day, they wanting to have the implant procedure. So I talk to them, I ask questions. In my experience, we have determined who are the ideal candidates with the best results. I don't want to get every patient who wants to get the implant to have an implant because they may not be a good candidate for this procedure. The best patients, in my opinion, are physically healthy and emotionally healthy patients with absolute realistic expectations. They are financially stable. If you want to borrow money, only try to finance a small amount so you can pay for it in a timely fashion. So you want to get a implant and you come to me and I sit down with you either in a virtual room or in the clinic and I examine your penis. If you have had fillers, any type of fillers in the past, automatically your risk of complications goes up tremendously. Therefore, if you are ever contemplating having a implant procedure, please don't do any fillers. Why is that? It's because every time you get fillers, you cause fibrosis and scar tissue in the penis. Your penis will lose its virginity. Therefore, now we're dealing with a scarred penis that has already been damaged and we cannot do the procedure. It tremendously increases risk of complications and infections. Therefore, if you are ever thinking about having a implant, simply contact us. Don't do fillers and say, if that doesn't work, I'll go talk to Dr. Taj. Talk to me first, and if you want to do fillers still, go ahead and do it. What is the next step? You decided to get the implant, and you want to come and see us. You chose the surgery date. The best time to do surgery is when you have at least 2 weeks time off, where you can rest, you can relax. You have to take several weeks off. You arrive the day before the surgery, you rest, you get a lot of plenty of sleep, and the day of the surgery, you come in, we will evaluate you again, we'll get intravenous access. I perform the procedures under intravenous sedation, so you will be comfortably asleep. After the procedure is done, you will be taken to the recovery, and after about an hour in the recovery, you will be discharged to a hotel or with your family members or friends to your house. You will return the next morning. I will examine you. I will check everything myself. I will change your dressing, and then I will see you again in average 3 days to remove your plastic drain, which is required to prevent fluid retention or hematoma or bleeding. After the drain is removed, you can fly back to your destination. If you live more than 2 hours away, do not drive to your destination. You must fly. The reason is that sitting in the car can increase risk of bleeding and complications. You cannot have sex or masturbation for 6 to 8 weeks. Another thing that I always hear is people text me and say, I want to go to gym and work out. Listen, you just spend all this money having an enlargement procedure. That area is swollen, it is inflamed, and by going to gym and lifting heavy weights, you increase pressure in that area, can create bleeding and what we call seroma, which is going to complicate things. So how do you manage it? Don't do it. Just relax, watch movies, and eat, drink water, no alcohol, no smoking, and just relax. As a surgeon, I also consider different factors in evaluating patients who want to get the implant. Number one, are they circumcised? Do they have erectile dysfunction? Do they have Peyronie's disease, or what we call curvature of the penis? It's extremely important for me to know how your penis is in an erect state so I can identify issues that need to be resolved before the surgery. For example, if you have uncircumcised penis, it is crucial and required that you be circumcised, because when you have a lot of foreskin that is loose in the head of the penis, when you get the implant, that is a potential space for fluid accumulation. So what happens is you will have a ballooning effect in that area, and it can complicate things, cause tissue damage and thinning of the skin and potential rupture of that area. So we always require circumcision at least 12 weeks before surgery. I perform circumcision under local anesthesia with your own music. I give you nitrous, which is the laughing gas. You will enjoy the music you're listening to. You can talk to us, you tell us jokes. Now, you have erectile dysfunction. Do you respond to oral ED medications or no? If you do respond to oral ED medications, what is the dose that you require? What is it that is causing your erectile dysfunction? Are you diabetic? Are you a smoker? Do you have extremely high blood pressure? Are you obese? These are the factors that you need to resolve before you consider having any cosmetic surgery, because as a young person, erectile dysfunction is a completely correlated to cardiovascular disease. You shouldn't have a implant until you're fully evaluated for erectile dysfunction. Let's say you are fully treated for underlying conditions and you are still requiring oral ET medications, but you get a good erection. Then we can consider having a implant procedure for you with addition of medications. What if you have curvature of the penis? I would like to know, how curved is it? What is the degree of curvature? What is the angle of the curvature? How bad is it? I would like to see images of your erect penis to see if there is a correction that needs to be made prior to having the implant procedure. The good news is, in many cases of dorsal curvature, where the penis is bending upward less than 30 degrees, the implant itself can help correct that curvature somewhat. Obviously, there are many other factors. The number one factor is your safety. We want you to have an excellent result. It is my duty that you have a satisfying result. Sometimes I may have to deny you surgery. It's for your own best interest, because I don't want to take your money and you have a poor outcome. So what is the process to be evaluated? I set up virtual consultations almost 5 to 6 times a day with men around the world. The process of obtaining a virtual or clinic consultation with me is very easy. They can set up a phone or their computer to enter a virtual room. I typically perform these in the afternoons or after hours in the privacy of your home or in your office in a private area. Patients can ask me any questions. I also interact with them. I explain the procedure in great detail. I make sure that they fully understand the procedure preoperatively, intraoperatively, and after the surgery, and what are their expectations. I always want to learn, what is it that they are trying to achieve? Is it erect length or erect girth? I want to make sure that they fully understand what is it that they want the implant to do for them. The process includes a physical examination by showing me their penis and stretching the penis to see how elastic the penis is. After the consultation, patients can continue conversations with us and ask questions. And if they decide to move forward, we can start the process of setting up a date and having the surgery done at the time of their choosing or at their convenience.